Hello, adventure lovers, and welcome to A Walk Through the Conversion. This is your host, Vidushi. We hope by now you're aware about this series. If not, Walk Through the Conversion is where we take a slow-paced walk through the conversions that we have previously revealed. In today's episode, we will be walking through Royal Kidding. Based on a Tata 15x12 4200 wheelbase chassis, this 11 sleeper home on wheels is as majestic as its name. So without the further ado, let's walk in. The exterior comes with a royal combination of red and white. There's ample storage in the caravan, not just on the inside, but also on the outside, making it a perfect home for a big fat family of 11. Now let's explore the kitchen. Speaking of which, this here is where you can store the cutleries, utensils, and LPG. What looks like nothing converts into a fully functional KitchenAid. The awning and the camping setup with slide-out kitchen countertop, which comes with a basin, burner, and grill top, makes the night in the middle of a jungle even more sizzling. There's also a pivoting nook to store all the kitchen essentials such as condiments and spices. The top lid serves as a skeleton to provide light on the kitchen top and can also be used to pitch up a tent. Right above the kitchen, we have a compact sleeping space to sleep the onboard staff. Now, this is something that you cannot see but would require essentially. Under the caravan, there's a 500-liter freshwater tank and a 100-liter blackwater tank. On top of the caravan, we have a 500-watt solar panel as well as a carrier space which you can use to pitch up the tent. You know the drill? Let's hop on to the cabin now. Although we have provided a separate sleeping space for the onboard staff, we still have provided a convertible seating and sleeping space for one onboard in the cabin. Now that we are done here, let's experience the actual home that Royal Kidding is. The entryway greets us through the custom-made bifold slide-in staircase. We will first explore the amenities towards my left. Now, because this is a bigger chassis-based caravan, we were able to create a bountiful bathroom. There's also a pneumatic activating valve-based come-out as well as shower space with both hot and cold water supply. On the top, we also have provision of curtain so that everything around the space could be clean and dry. On the top of the wash basin, we have a vanity space with storage behind and underneath. Stepping out the bathroom to my right is a wall space dedicated to an electricity control panel, a valve to store all your essential items, a microwave, 180-liter 12x24-volt DC battery-operated fridge, and more storage. To my left is a display closet with a drop-down seat attached to it. The area was wisely designed to space a collapsible ladder within. On the top, we have a 6.5-feet drop-down bed. There's actually a total of 4 such beds in the caravan. There's a total of 2 dining stations in this caravan, each of which get converted into a sleeping space for 2 onboard. There's also a spill-proof compartment for the glasses. Dividing both the dining stations is an edgy-looking wooden design, which, just like the storage under the sofa, provides filling space for a group of 11. And that's not it. I'm actually standing on one of the storage compartments, adjacent to which is a sofa that also serves as a bed. On the top, we have a 2.2 cassette AC, which, just like the whole interior of this caravan, has been uniquely designed with a teak wooden finish, providing the vintage cottage vibes on wheels. There are also final few amenities like a TV, music system, battery-operated lights all over, charging socket. Now, if you've been calculating, you must be thinking, but Vidushi, you said there are a total of 11 beds, but this only makes 9. Well, I saved the best one for the last, the most majestic and royal of all, the cab over bed, on which you can hop onto using the collapsible ladder. Now, to show you the next feature, I'll actually have to hop onto the cab over bed. Making the master bed self-sufficient, we have a cabinet on top that stores the blankets, bed liners, pillow covers, and whatnot. And that, my friends, concludes this episode of A Walk Through the Conversion. This is actually my first time concluding a video like this. So on that note, make sure to like this video and share it with other people. Subscribe to our channel, for we will be posting many more conversion and travel videos in the Home Away Home on Wheels. I'm now actually going to enjoy this home on wheels with an afternoon nap. Thank you so much for coming by. Motorhome Adventures signing off. A safety valve ban kiya kya. Making the master bed a self-sufficient, making